event, a matchup for the UFC lightweight division title. All right, here he is, the number one lightweight contender, making his way to the octagon and looking to lead as the new undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world. He has bided his time, waiting for this title shot. He's got the winning streak. He has the quality of opposition. Now he's fighting the number one guy in the world.
You ready? You ready?
All right, so here we go with the start of round one. I can tell how excited you are for this matchup. Seems to be a striking advantage on one side, but maybe not.
This is a big-time fight. It feels like a big moment for both of these guys' careers. Who is going to be able to implement their game plan the best in this matchup between these two big-time athletes?
Opens up with a front kick. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the center. Big kick land.
They're certainly getting after it early.
He is throwing a fast, straight, hard jab. That's not a fueler jab. That's one that's really knocking the head back.
All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot. That's just something.
And he connects there, DC.
Great job landing that one.
While this striker knows one direction, that is forward. He knows one style, that is aggressive. And that's exactly what we've seen tonight.
He has every intent of overwhelming every guy he steps into the octagon with. And he's doing that up to this point of the first round. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this?
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Max Holloway. Oh, he lands a straight punch there, DC. We'll see if he can follow it up now.
He has been throwing his strike over and over again. Look how crisp and straight he is. Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body with that body kick.
Ooh, blocks the shot.
Big powerful punch lands. Now we get back in range.
All right, throws a straight punch and lands. So that is increasingly becoming an effective weapon for him tonight.
This is one of his best strikes, and he's throwing it over and over again.
He's trying to double up on that jab. And he landed the right hand there. Man, it ain't Dikembe Mutombo, but he is blocking all these shots coming
man,
his way.
Man, get that out of here. He sees it coming. You're going to have to mix it up.
Shake that finger.
Shake that finger. Oh, that's a nice strike.
Left hand is true. That will absolutely work.
He throws.
Despite the score, how's his opponent still standing?
I mean, I have no idea. This fight is supposed to be over. And it might not be over now, but it's got to be over very soon.
Okay, you ready? Round two. You ready? Let's go, guys. Fight.
Oh, big punch lands.
Lands with the right hand. Wow!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, he might be out.
Wow.
Oh, man. This grounded pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates distance and space to land these beautiful grounded pound combinations. What a punch.
Punch is blocked. try to establish that jab. And another big kick for Max Holloway. Well, no surprises.
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right point.
Oh!
That knee. That knee hurt him.
Well, he's really starting to land a high number of strikes here in the second round. No denying that he has taken the message.
Oh! Hurt bad, John. He's got to press it. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Blocks the shot. So another swing and a miss, and I'd imagine if your gas tank is this low, you got to find times to try to preserve that energy and get yourself back to a place where you can actually dole out some damage.
Yeah, you got to get out to space, find places to rest and recover, get against the octagon, go to the clinch, find ways to just recover so that when you have that next explosion, it actually has some meaning to it.
Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
All right, so a good job defensively by him here as he raises the guard and prevents any damage.
Shades of James Toney. Always seeing things coming at him. He's such a great defensive fighter.
And that's the end of round number two. All right, so that's the end of the round. Pretty significant damage to him. Here we go, third round of this championship fight.
Punch over the top.
Whoa!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, he is up, but man, is he hurt. A finish could come here at any time. Trying to establish that jab once again. Well,
oh! He's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
All right, dominant position here. He's got the full mount. A lot of different ways he can go here. Maybe try to find an arm bar or just get the ground and pound.
He can attack submission, but those submissions will present themselves once he is landing that brutal ground and pound he is known for. Because then his opponent will start to get a little bit desperate to get out from under him, which will then in turn leave arms dangling, or he'll turn to his knees and get choked out.
All right, so a good job by him here. He continues to block these shots. Seems to see them coming a mile away.
He sees them coming a mile away, and he's blocking, he's rolling, he's slipping. He's doing a great job.
Oh, lands another beautiful strike to the body, really starting to connect at will when it comes to working the body, and especially effective doing it. Nice defense there. Huge block. Just misses with that one. Oh! He's out!
Unbelievable! Oh, my goodness. What a fight.
You knew if he landed that weapon repeatedly, it could be a short night for his opponent. But that was just one perfectly placed strike that his opponent candidly didn't even see coming. It landed flush, and the rest, as they say, is history. Big knockout win for him here. Let's get it to Bruce Buffer.